We're going to be making an incision here in a previously extracted grafted scenario here. The patient had a tooth extracted about 4 months ago and done an alloplast graft that worked very, very nicely. But as you know, sometimes we have pneumatization of the sinus, and that then ends up working out very, very nicely for us. But we'd like to have an implant that potentially gets into the 10 millimeter range versus 8.5 if we possibly can do it. So we're going to be able to utilize our burrs to be able to use our Versa burr so we can bump this sinus up a couple of millimeters. We'll be able to basically take some autogenous bone and, just utilizing technology, be able to increase the height of bone. So hopefully we're going to be able to put a 3.8 by 10 millimeter implant that will give him a very, very nice long-term result. So that's the goal right now. So we're going to reflect the soft tissue, maintaining keratinized tissue on both the buccal and lingual, so that when we ultimately end up restoring this, we've got an excellent outcome with both hard and soft tissue. So now we're going to move the tissue. Try to get the tissue away from the molar and the premolars. Can I help?
Yeah, I think there's just no room over here for it.
Mm-hmm. Yep. So that's what we're doing right now, is just kind of manipulating the soft tissue so we can visualize our bone so we can start utilizing the Versa burr kit. Yeah. Karen, can you move the arm of the x-ray from this? It's catching that. Does that help? Destin, is that better? Okay, thank you. All right, so we've got our tissue reflected, both buccal and lingual. And so now we're going to go in there. You can kind of see where the tooth used to be. Look good. Be careful with using. So we're going to utilize our anatomy here to get this implant started. Make sure we're maintaining buccal lingual angulation. Utilizing our anatomy here to help with mesiodistal angulation as well. So we've got everything lined up. And we're going to take our 700XXL right in the center of the ridge. Go right down into the bone, open that up, and then we'll go ahead and start out with our pilot drill. All right, so we've just double checked our measurements to make sure that we know exactly where we're going to take our initial pilot drill to, and this will then get us the beginning of our journey. So now we've already started things in our now we're just going to go up and down, up and down, up and down, go to that initial thin black line. Once we get it to where we're needing to be, that, there we go. I have a tendency to do that too when I'm concentrating. It's harder to speak up. Going to take an intraoperative x-ray? Mm-hmm. All right, perfect. So we're going to put our pilot drill right into the initial osteotomy. We're going to take a quick x-ray here. There you go. Butimus. That looks fantastic. Yep. Start the protocol process here of, now we've got things in reverse.
What's that speed up?
And now we're just densifying our bone. So we just went from 200 to 500 with our RPMs here. Just slowly, this is which drill?
1828.
This is the 1828 drill. Now we're just trying to push that up just a little bit higher. So now we've got a 2535, and just kind of push that up just a little bit more. This is a 3338, is that right? 2838. 2838, yeah. So this tapers a whole entire millimeter from apex to coronal. So again, the idea behind this is to push this apically. You don't have implants out, do you, Karen?
Nope.
Okay. Julissa? This is out to be able to seat that. Do you have the kit out to seat that?
I just need that.
Okay. We good?
Well, that's an active recall.
Well, I've got both of them. I just wanted to know whether or not you had,
nope.
You don't have it, right?
Nope.
How's everything look apically in there? Yeah. Looks good. So the question was, do we, with the design of this implant, since the cortical bone is fairly thick, it is we're needing to actually, and unfortunately not going to be able to see it because of how he has to, because this burr is a little shorter. So we just need to open up this coronal portion just slightly so that the 3.8 by 10 millimeter keystone active implant will be engaged so we can actually get the implant seated. So hopefully you'll be able to see now that we've put the extension on there. You can see this just kind of barely opens up this most coronal portion of our preparation here. There you go. Good. So now we're going to seat our 3.8 by 10 millimeter Keystone Active. You can see the implant there. The implant goes in initially, and then we can see it. And we're just going to use our hand tightening. Now we'll put our torque wrench in place. And yep, there we go. Awesome. Look how beautiful that is. What's our, where are we at torque value wise now? 50?
Yeah.
Yep. It's even higher than that now, isn't it? Yeah, we're at 60 now. So we're just going to get this about a half millimeter subcrestal. And that should be really nice. We've got that little flute out to the facial. That will set things up very, very nicely for our restorative complex when it comes, you know, 4 months down the road. Man, that is one long instrument. Is that your lefty instrument? I hear you. Do you like it? Do you like that better than a hemostat?
I do, because I can just click it off and then put that on it. This one's a little big.
I had found your other one and put it in the age drawer, but it's gone again.
But this big one is actually...
I took it out of an uncover kit, and it's probably... I don't know where it ended up after sterilization. $5,000 of tape on it. I think it was a record.
I like this veterinary one.
Full throat to where it's going to be floral with her. Yeah, I don't know how that happened, but the tail came off.
What just happened? Maybe he got caught on his beard. That happens to me so many times. So now we're putting our sutures in. We've got a PTFE suture, so we're going to go 3 forward, 2 forward. That'll work out really nicely. 1 reverse. And then 1 forward. And that will tie things down really nicely here on the mesial. Always want to get that mesial done first, so we get that soft tissue looking awesome.
Keep that up there, could you keep moving it in front of me? That's okay.
Now we'll do our distal suture. So, is that better? Yeah. There you go. Oh, is that two or three?
So you just need to use
I know.
Sinus.
I know. Karen's taking care of you, though. Always, always does. He's just breathing. He remembered. I'm gonna go one day without something hitting the floor. Just one day.
That wouldn't be a dental office.
Huh?
That wouldn't be a dental office.
I know, right? So in our discussion prior to starting, we mapped out our incision. We're gonna leave that papilla intact just on the distal aspect of 11. We're going to go up into the non-keratinized tissue and make a vertical, staying away from the canine eminence, so that makes it easier for us to suture things together.
You want to wait?
No, you can go ahead and go. Yep, you're good. So we're going to just kind of come push right through keratinized tissue, going straight down all the way to bone, and just kind of leave that papilla intact, and then we'll go to the crest of the ridge, make our incision there,
and
this way we'll be able to keep our anterior incision away from the actual entry into the sinus. That's the one of the goals why we're making our anterior releasing incision, is to give us better access so we can visualize things, but also it's to potentially keep the bacteria away from the site where we're entering. Yeah. Yep, I totally agree with you. So we're going to make a distal releasing incision as well. This will enable us to lay our flap the way we need to. So now we're just going to retrace our steps with our curved blade. This enables us to make sure those little tendrils that are sticking down into the bone, we get all those, and it makes it easier for us to make a good, simple, clean reflection. Can I help you? Sorry. It's right over here, darling.
Okay.
I'm just enjoying it. Just enjoy things.
No, I'm just not doing it at all. I'm just trying to help.
But it is funny.
Got this blue film over it. Just a little bit of
So does he have a little bit of perio here? Kind of seems like a little bit of granulation tissue between the teeth. So you like the Heller roll?
Of course.
There you go. Nicely done. All right, beautiful. Look at that. Now you got a nice, solid, clean reflection. Yep. There you go. Good deal. Now we'll get that distal releasing incision, and then we'll be able to come up in here and... Not wanting to let go.
All right. Yeah.
What happened?
It just fell over.
Just on its own? So one of the things that we noticed on our CBCT was that he may not have a lot of crustal height of bone, but his what bone he does have is very, very thick and dense. Yes. Is that better?
I'm in the way right now.
Yep. I mean, it might help in the future, but you know, right now he's got everything reflected pretty well. As long as he stays where he's at, we should be just fine. So kind of outline where you think you want to make your window. Does that, so you want to be little more mesial, I think, because the hardest part about this reflection, the reflection of the membrane, the further that your opening is, the harder that's going to be to get to that. So we want to stay away from the apex of the tooth, but we got to stay as mesial as we possibly can. So
I might be angling the camera. I think I'm
about. Okay, it could be. So this is works best. Look here, when it's kind of going like this, it's most effective when you're kind of rocking it. Yeah.
So, does this have like an extension by any chance?
I don't know if you'd have room. You kind of just have to manipulate your hand to give you a purchase point. It can be a challenge at times, but I think you're, if you manipulate the back end of the handpiece up anteriorly, that will work out. There you go, just like that. Is that better? Maybe, maybe not. Yeah.
It's just because it's so steep of an angle.
I know. The way that kicks out buckly. Yep. Yep. So get in there, you know, take some away, and then we may have to kick over to the piezo.
Yeah.
Just do what you can with this, and then we'll see how that works. Now, you got to push your foot on that and keep it all the way down, because if you're not pushing all the way down, it's not using its... There you go, just like that. Just do that, that's perfect. Good job. See how it's just kind of wiping that away? Mm-hmm. And it'll push the membrane away once you get towards it. There you go. That is awesome. No, it's over there. Did it come off?
Yeah.
Need help? Now we're using our piezo just to get the last vestigial portions of the buccal bone. So we get down to the Schneiderian membrane and have access to try to manipulate this. Hit it every frickin' time. Are you good? Okay. Yeah. We're gonna have to turn his back head back to the right, guys.
Tom, we're gonna turn your head to the right. Thank you.
There you go, much better. Yep, that looks great. You feeling the membrane at all anywhere?
Yeah, on the top of the distal, I'm starting to feel it.
Okay.
It's just, I think it's just the inferior portion of the foot.
You press on that and see if you get any movement?
Yeah, not yet.
Okay. Do you know how to work this? Do you know where to do that?
Over there?
Yeah.
You dump this?
No, you just leave it in there and just make okay. Me add another one there, please. Thank you. Thank you. where I, is it over here? One of these?
Uh-huh.
Any one of them? Actually, let's try to use this one. Tell him to stop a second. Stop a second, John. All right, you're good. There you go. Get the scoop. Or not. There you go. Attaboy. Good job. Excellent, excellent, excellent. Nicely done. Nicely. So how many, you for the fentanyl, did you dilute that to 50 mics per milligram?
Yep.
And so you start out with 5 cc's?
Nope.
How many, just how much?
Just
two.
Just only two. Giving 50.
Yeah, okay. I just want to make sure.
need a swallow again? You need a swallow again?
Did that piezo push that away pretty easily? Looks like it's pretty robust membrane.
Yeah, I think so.
So, can you free it up distally just a little?
Yeah, I was about to just go distally in.
Yeah, and then start, then once you get mesial or distal, that'll free it up on the mesial a little bit so you have less of a chance of snagging it. There you go. Yeah, sometimes all of a sudden now you can't get your instrumentation in here because your window's not big enough. So you just gotta be careful with this. And if you need to, open your window more. But if you don't, then you don't. Now, can you catch and move the crestal over to the medial wall completely and then start?
Yeah,
that's next. Yep. It looks like it's moving nicely. Yep, you're doing a great job. Karen, if you can get that cheek back just a little, that'd be great. Thank you. And suction on that distal for me, please. Thank you. Moving pretty well. Looks like it is. That's one of my favorite instruments right there. Didn't that come with the kit, right? That and the yellow instrument? Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And then there's three other ones in there that we never used.
What were the three other ones? I can't remember even seeing them.
Similar to this.
Oh, so that's for packing in a mm-hmm. Crestal kit. Mm-hmm. I've just never even used that. I mean, to be quite honest with you, I don't even know if I've seen it. Probably have, just never used it. Yep. Huh, interesting. Okay. So you said there's three more or two more?
There's another one, but it's off the field because I use it to open the
bone. I got you. So why don't you blot in there, give yourself a little bit more vision. See what things look like. Wow, nice. Looky there. How high have you moved that up on the media wall there, you think?
This really probably like close 8.
Okay. There you go. Nice. See if you can't get that suction distally and pull some of that heme out of there. Just hold your instrument on the membrane and then let her get that suction there. There you go. Good.
I think I just got that portion of the
Did you?
Get that ghost in there one more time and I'll see where I'm at.
Okay. So you're going to do your preparation today, or are you just going to add bone? It really depends on you, the practitioner, as to what you feel is the right protocol. So if you're thinking you'd rather just do the graft and then come back 4 months later, that's fine. If you feel like you've got enough that from a clinical standpoint, the situation would warrant placing it at this time, then
yeah, I think so too.
You know.
But also I didn't tell him that we were planning on placing an implant today, I don't think.
Okay.
So
if that's not part of the treatment plan today,
Yeah. Then
just do your graft. Yeah. That's fine. Not a problem. Not a problem. Because it looks like, you know, the way you've got everything elevated.
Yeah, probably got it right here.
You know, you've got, yeah, so I would say, you know, everything is so intact, I don't think you need to put a cytoplasm membrane in there. I say you just put in one or two PRF membranes, you know, and then pack your bone in there, and then cover it up. It looks really good. really, really good. I mean, he's billowing nicely. You know, it's...
Ready?
He's breathing well. I mean, it looks really good. You got
six.
You got five now, okay?
Then just one more, then we'll do the last one.
Yeah, perfect. Okay there, Jade.
Huh?
You doing okay?
Yeah. I just
need to stay. Yep, I get it. Totally get it. So we've raised our membrane up, we've used all our curettes, we've placed two PRF membranes inside the site, and we opted not to use a cytoplasm membrane because there was no tears, and so now we're just placing our bone in here, and we're going to be filling this up. We will pack it in there, not too tight, but not loosely, so we make sure we get a good clean fill. And we're using Rocky Mountain Tissue Bank bone, which is a larger particle irradiated bone. It's a cortical cancellous bone chip. We've added, what did we add in there, Karen?
Salvinos, Cerasaur, and Dinosaur.
And we've added a smaller particle corticocancellous mineralized bone graft. We've added tricalcium phosphate. And what else? Yeah.
Dinosaur.
Okay, so both. Okay, so we've got the right little cocktail we typically use which is, you know, we want it, we need to get some substance in there that will give us the ability to see the bone when we take a radiograph. There's always the situation where you add your bone. If you haven't added some sort of radiopaque substance, you don't see it on the x-ray. So we've got about 10 or 15% of a bovine bone that will give us the radiopacity so that when we take our x-ray, we'll know that we've got a good clean fill. So that's what we're doing right now. We're just kind of filling this. Starting to get some resistance now. Do you need more bone?
Oh, yeah, for sure.
Uh-oh. No, I'm asking Karen. How much was that?
That's what I was just sitting here thinking.
Was that two or three of?
It's like two and a half.
And then
I used a half Rocky Mountain, one Salvinos, one Dynacor, and then a little bit of Cerasaur.
Yeah.
Okay. Want to be too crazy since it was just a single site.
Yeah. Yep. Just looks like it's so loosely packed in there that we need some more. Question is how much? You think you need another cc of Rocky Mountain? Or a half? I just can't tell. Looks like it's moving around pretty.
Yeah,
so I'm thinking, you know. And we're certain there were no tears, correct?
Yeah, it's still building.
Yeah. Right. So, you getting any resistance on the... Karen, I can help you open that, honey. Are we getting any resistance at all? It does appear to be. Is this is 3 grams? You're going to have like half that left over or more. No problem. Happy to do it. Sons of bitches. Just ran out.
Yes, it was.
So now we're putting in our orostruct over top of the window. This will help prevent soft tissue invagination while we're healing. So one of the reasons why you probably had that much is if you pushed back distally and now you're adding bone, that back portion probably went up quite a bit. So you didn't just add for one, so you added enough so that should he lose that distal tooth, you'd have more bone apically.
Yeah.
And actually, to be quite honest with you, that's what I try to do, because it keeps you from having to go in and do another procedure. And I think it's fair to the patient, because you're already in there. Why do another sinus elevation, right? Yep. So now we'll put our PRF membrane over that window as well. We got what, two more?
Yeah.
Yeah, so let's put one over top of the crest of the ridge and another one over top of the window, and we'll suture it together. It looks just beautiful. Nice piece of surgery, Dr. Shin.
Thank you very much.
Really nice piece of surgery.
We don't have an X-ray set. I want to put one under the anterior release if we have some.
So you want to save this and put it?
I would like one over the crest. Just like slightly over the crest and then one like right underneath the anterior.
You gotta have one or the other.
I'll do crest now because it's not.
That just looks so gorgeous. Those PRF membranes are beautiful on him, aren't they?
It brings out his eyes.
Yeah. I was thinking the same thing. What about the soft tissue? Is that going to have to relieve that much, or...? Using the back end of that. I can't tell whether you're using the... Oh, there you go. It was in the blood. I couldn't tell whether you're using the actual front end or the back end of it. Nice. Pull up and out. Use the side of that blade to... There you go.